Since its introduction in 1980, the M1 Abrams has served as the US Army's premier main battle tank for the last 40 years, and seems destined to remain in US inventories forever. Key to this success has been the upgradability of the M1, with a variety of improvements and new features ensuring the Abrams remains competitive on the battlefield. Today we look at the M1 Improved Performance, the first major upgrade from the base model, which saw an increase in armor protection and improvements in the quality of life for the crew. Welcome to another Tank Encyclopedia voiced article. I'm your host, Wood, and today I'll be covering the M1IP, the first large-scale upgrade for the Abrams. If you like what we do and want to see more of it, don't forget to like the video, and if you haven't already, subscribe so you don't miss a single upload. The M1IP was designed as a stopgap measure between the M1 and the M1A1. Studies indicated that Soviet ammunition was becoming increasingly more lethal, and there was also a desire that some features of the M1E1, the test mule for the M1A1, would be incorporated, while the studies on other components and features were still underway. Many key components of the M1 remained unchanged. The M1IP still mounted the M68 105mm main gun, and it was still powered by the AGT 1500C multi-fuel turbine engine. Between the two, you could tell the M1IP apart by its bustle rack at the rear of the turret, giving the crew more room to store their gear. In addition, the side skirts of the original M1 were modified, originally covering about half the rear sprocket. They had a tendency to build up mud and cause the track to come out of alignment. In the field, a lot of crews just cut off that portion of the rear skirt, or simply removed the entire section. On the M1IP, a smooth, blended cut was made around the rear sprocket to alleviate this problem. Both the bustle rack and the cutout side skirt remain distinctive features of the Abrams today. The biggest change, although a little less obvious, was the application of a larger armor module to improve protection from anti-tank weapons. Overall, the M1's frontal armor was increased to provide an additional 50 millimeters of protection against kinetic rounds, for a total of 450 millimeters of rolled homogeneous equivalent, as well as an extra 200 millimeters of protection against chemical energy ammunition, such as high explosive anti-tank, for a total of 900 millimeters of rolled homogeneous equivalent. This increase in armor also included a thicker gun mantlet, which was slightly redesigned for the M1IP. The gunner's auxiliary sight was split between two armor faces rather than one, giving the appearance of part of the sight having been cut off. Alongside the change in design of the front lifting bracket from a straight piece to a gooseneck design, these rather subtle changes are a more reliable way of identifying an M1IP from the basic M1, especially with the addition of the rear bustle rack to the base M1 in the form of a retrofit kit. A final change was also the moving of the tow cables on the turret sides, which were moved further back on the turret cheeks. The new turret design and added armor came at a cost. The weight of the Abrams increased by about a ton and saw a decrease in speed from 45 miles per hour to about 41. Approximately 890 M1IPs were produced between 1984 and 1986. The tank was first issued stateside, then to armored units stationed in West Germany. The vehicle first rose to prominence in the 1987 Canadian Army Trophy Competition. Held in West Germany, the competition was intended to encourage competition and camaraderie between NATO allies. Beginning as a stationary competition at a gunnery range, by 1987 it evolved into a much more realistic facsimile of combat, involving a platoon of tanks performing a battle run, firing on the move and from stationary positions against mobile and immobile targets. The speed and accuracy of these runs determined a team's score. Although not the first time the M1IP had taken part, 1st Platoon of A Company, 4th Battalion of the 8th Cavalry Regiment, scored first place in the competition, and took home the Silver Centurion Trophy, the first and only win for the US in the competition's history. M1IPs would also be deployed to Saudi Arabia during Operation Desert Shield, as US and coalition forces prepared for the invasion of Iraq-occupied Kuwait. However, fearing the Iraqi T-72s were equipped with modern Soviet ammunition, most M1IPs, even some M1A1s, were replaced with M1A1 heavy armor variants, featuring a depleted uranium armor package to improve protection, as well as the more lethal M256 120mm cannon. By the start of the Operation Desert Storm, at least one battalion, the 3rd of the 37th Armored Regiment, still had their original M1IPs and used them to good effect. Throughout the 90s, the M1IP was gradually phased out of service by the newer M1A1 and A2 tanks. By 2000, most of the M1IPs and based M1 tanks had been relegated to the reserves. However, about 1,000 M1 and IPs underwent a total refit in the mid-2000s as part of the U.S. Army program. The tanks were upgraded to M1A2 standard, a cheaper alternative to just building them from scratch. Although an oft-overlooked model of the Abrams, the M1IP introduced a number of changes and modifications that remain visible even on more modern variants, from the bustle rack to the cut-down armor skirt and improved protection. While not as well-traveled as the M1A1 and A2, at its introduction it was still a solid tank for the U.S. Army, and in the hulls of some M1A2s, the spirit of the M1IP persists. This concludes our look at the M1IP. If you haven't already, consider becoming a subscriber so you don't miss out on a single video. If you want to contribute more directly, consider donating on Patreon or PayPal. The money comes back to you in the form of bigger and better videos. Until next time, keep us in your sights.